service together with me and my fellow youth. Welcome and be blessed. Makof, makof, kwaye.
Thank you. done, knowing your river and knowing me, with our eyes, with our tongue, with our feet, we have stepped in places that are pleasant and your rebel hands. May you have mercy upon our lives and forgive us, O Lord. We give you thanks and adoration for everything, O Lord, for everything that you have given unto us, O Lord. We adore your name and we give you all the praises, O Lord. Father God, heal our land, heal our lives, heal our family, O Lord. Let us see you through in everything that we do, O Lord. So it's a humble prayer of faith. We do pray this, believe and trust you. Amen.
Our reading will come from the book of 2 Kings, chapter 2, verse 1 to 3. It says, "Now when the Lord was about to take Elijah up to heaven by whirlwind, Elijah and Elisha were on their way from Gilgal. And Elijah said to Elisha, 'Please stay here, for the Lord has sent me as far as Bethel.' But Elisha said, 'As the Lord lives, and as you yourself live, I will not leave you.' So they went down to Bethel, and the sons of the prophets who were in the Bethel came out to Elisha and said to him, 'Do you know that today the Lord will take away your master from over you?' And say, 'Yes, I know it. Keep quiet. Be blessed.'"
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. My name is John Akairo, and I love the Lord as my personal Savior. Our message today is following Christ to the end. And we have read through the scripture from the book of 2 Kings, chapter 2, and from verse 1 up to verse 14, up to verse 3. But at your own time, you can read up to verse 14 because my message lies there. And as I read this scripture in the book of 2 Kings chapter 2, I see the journey of a Christian, of a disciple of Christ. Because Elisha is following his teacher, and they are walking on a journey. And it has come a time that Elijah is going back to heaven, and it's been taken away, Elisha knows. But there is something, if you look at that scripture, where you will see that there is something that Elisha is after. And as a Christian, I am seeing that we need to have this thing that was in Elisha. As a Christian, following Christ, and I can see that Elisha walked with Elijah until he got that which he expected of his master. And there are some cities that are mentioned there. If you read through that scripture, you see that those cities brings to us a picture of the journey of a Christian. Because I can see that they are walking from Gilgal. Gilgal is the beginning of the spiritual journey of the people of God. It brings a picture of the movement we believed in Christ Jesus, when the reproach of sin was taken away. And they went to Bethel. Bethel means the house of God. And as a Christian, we need to live in the house of God. As a disciple, as we follow Christ, we need to live in his presence. Because it is in his presence that we encounter him and experience of him. Then there is Jericho. Jericho brings a picture of conquest, that if we walk with Christ, as we go on with him, as we follow him, there is victory in our life. And then there is Jordan. Jordan was the final victory, the entrance into the promised land. And I'm telling you, Christians, if we follow Christ, if we walk with Christ and not turn back, we will see the promised land. Because there is a reward. And there are three things I want us to ponder as I finish. And number one is that we must surrender. If we want to walk with Christ to the end, we must surrender ourselves to him. You will see that in the book of 1 Kings chapter 19 and verse 19 to 21, the man of God, Elisha, left all things. He slaughtered his cows and cooked for people and left his life and followed Elisha. That is what God is calling us to as Christians. We must leave all. And Christ has reiterated that very many times, that if we are not able to leave all for him, we can never be his disciples. Therefore, we must surrender to him. Number two is perseverance. It might not be easy. It was not easy for Elijah. He was mocked. He was reminded of his weakness. He was reminded of his going, of the going of his master. But he said, hold your peace. I know it. Tell off your detractors and distractors. Tell them that you know it. Keep on keeping on. Because this is what a disciple is called unto. To persevere. Hallelujah. And this is what Christ is telling us time and again. Even in the epistles of the apostles, you see God is telling us to persevere. Even in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 16, verses, if you had time, you would read. But the Bible is very clear that we must persevere in order for us to get to where we have been called unto. And the last thing is the reward. Brethren, it is not in vain to walk with Christ and to follow Christ. There is a reward. If you read up to the end of that scripture, you will see that the man of God received what he expected and what he desired. A double portion of the anointing of Elijah. Hallelujah! We shall get the reward if we persevere to the last. Praise the Lord. Brethren, it is not in vain. Let us persevere and follow Christ to the end. Let us pray. We thank you, our Lord, for your word. And we thank you for reminding us that we need to walk with you to the end. May you help us to persevere as we focus on what you have called us unto. In Jesus' name we pray. Now in the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Amen.